Nick Knowles pops in to join Paul O'Grady at 5. First on 4, Noel proves he knows a thing or two about his contestants, but will the embarrassment be worth the big money?
$22, £250,000, just one question. Welcome to Deal or No Deal. We're motoring at the moment. I have to say, nobody has won the mega money for just a little while, but we are getting people coming out here with a very positive attitude, and we like that. And do you know why they're so positive? Because we look after them. We look after every single little detail of their lives when they're at the hotel, and then they come here, and we put thought in, which I'm not sure they fully appreciate. So let me just put this to the test. You, sir, Mark, I believe, are a plasterer.
I am, yes.
And you have a penchant for really detailed work when you're up on the scaffolding and you step back to admire it. Yes?
I do, yes.
What did you used to do for a job?
District nurse.
Nurse. We've got a nurse next to a man determined to kill himself. Here, we've got a nurse. And when Lisa started her nursing career, they asked her to go and get a bedpan for someone who was a bit desperate. And she came back with a sick bowl. And when this guy, Ryan, was in a pub chatting up a girl, the girl popped to the restroom. He was so ill, he threw up in her glass. He needed the sick bowl that you had. I know it's disgusting, but it's a perfect pairing. They really get on well, these two. Here come the names. Hopefully, Christmas has indeed come very early for you, cos it's... Yes, you, Lisa!
Oh, my God!
Come on, Lisa. Time to give the banker a taste of your medicine. Hello.
Hello. I knew you were going to start with that.
Do please.
Oh, thank you.
Have you always had that problem?
Yeah. My brother's got the same. When we went to Chessington, we both get the giggles. So on the ride, we're just full of hysterical laughter as we're going around each one.
Is it because you're simple?
No.
Lisa Barnard. From Clacton-on-Sea, originally from Surrey.
Yes.
A trainee nurse. Tell me about meeting your fiancé, Jimmy.
He went on holiday, and when I met him, he told me his name was Jimmy. And about 6 months later, I finally met his parents. I went to their house, and his mum asked me to call him for dinner. So I was calling. She said, could you get Julian for me, please? And I said, sorry, who's Julian? And she looked at me a bit strangely, and she said, Julian. And I didn't realise his name isn't actually Jimmy, it's actually Julian.
So for 6 months he'd lied to you about his name?
Yeah, he didn't actually tell me.
This doesn't strike me as a very trusting relationship. Which order do you want to do these in?
This one.
This one, right, OK. Yeah. Oh, that's a handsome brute.
Yeah. He looks like Phil Mitchell. He's going to kill me for saying that. He actually likes carp fishing, and that's where he is at the moment. He's in France for a week, that's why I couldn't be here today.
Couldn't be here. No, sorry, Lisa.
Chose
to be with fish like that rather than here, possibly having his life changed forever.
Yeah, but that was one of the biggest fish that he'd caught, so the reason I brought that photo was hopefully if that was his biggest fish, I might win some big money today.
Did he put it back?
Yeah, you have to.
You have to?
Yeah, you have to put carp back. You spend ages, sometimes even weeks, catching this fish, then you literally get it out, weigh it, take a photo and put it back. That's it.
Right. Why would anybody want to do that?
I don't know.
And who's that?
That's my daughter. She's beautiful. She's 4 years old. I don't quite know what she's looking at. She is. She's like Shirley Temple.
Maybe she's actually saying to you,
Mummy, why is Daddy kissing that fish?
What else do we need to know? Or should we start?
Yeah, I would.
What I think is going to be a giggle. Sure. What are you laughing at now? What are you laughing at? There's one little bit of housekeeping, and that is I need you, please, to confirm. Now I've got it. Sorry. I need you, please, to confirm that you chose box number 2 at random before the game began.
I did, yes.
It is sealed by the independent adjudicator who seals all 22 boxes and is the only person who knows where the money is. Apart from giggling your way through it, how are you going to play this game?
I don't know. Completely random. I've not got any numbers at all.
Lisa, I wish you all possible success.
Thank you.
Good luck! Oh, well, relax, because it will go very quickly. I want a decent giggle from each one as you open the box.
For number 22, Stan.
Oh, Stan! Oh, with the death box.
I'll tell you why, because everyone keeps calling it the death box, because at the beginning it was, but lately it's been throwing out quite a lot of blues. So I'm just going to get it out of the way.
Let's go.
Very good.
Let's start with a blue. There! Yeah!
Second best start.
Number 13, Harry. Please.
It's you, Harry.
Oh, all the best to you, Lisa.
Thank you.
Yeah! The third best start you've been having. Could you do it? We've never had the perfect start.
One, Billy.
Go on, Bill.
Best luck.
Thank you.
Yeah! Another blue. Well done,
Number 4, Jane.
Good luck, Lisa.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jane.
Number 18, Sandy.
Okay, please. Sandy, we're with you. No more damage, please. It's all right. I'll get it. You make yourself comfortable.
Okay, I fidget.
Hello! No, no, that giggling doesn't get irritating. It's uplifting. Ah, he's irritated by your laugh. He doesn't like humour and happiness.
It's because I'm nervous.
But she's nervous. Oh, what is today? Today? I mean, what? Oh! Gadzooks! It's our 900th show! Does she get something extra special?
It's worth a try.
Oh, yes, he says. Would you like something long and wriggly? Eel or no eel?
That was good.
Ooh, he's rather worried, actually, a little concerned because of your humorous exterior, your positivity, the giggling. This sort of bright, radiant personality. He can't see through you. It's like looking through a fog. He's trying to get to the real Lisa. Wow. Well, he thinks underneath that giggly, vacant exterior, there almost certainly is a giggly, vacant interior.
That's nice.
I think it was worthy of more of a reaction than that. You know? But you must be doing something right. He's offering you now, for this box, £7,900.
How many shoes and handbags could I buy with that?
Lot of accessories. You want the dream honeymoon, don't you?
Well, I want to help my dad, because my poor dad's... I'm a real daddy's girl, so he wants to pay for everything and he works hard, so I want to try and...
Save him having to work so hard?
Yeah.
That's
pay my little bit towards it, yeah.
Dream honeymoon in Dubai?
Yeah, in that big sail hotel.
But he'll go off fishing.
Yeah, it's okay. I like sunbathing anyway, so I'm quite happy. I get some peace and quiet. Okay, I'm ready for the question.
£7,900, deal or no deal?
No deal.
Thank you.
I'm going to go with the lovely Lauren, please. Good luck, Lisa.
Thank you, Lauren. Thank you.
My little doll Mio man, Vincenzo, and I'm 16.
I'll give you a wonderful blue.
Hope so, not green.
I hope so.
It's like a blood.
Blue or green design.
So, why should they come back?
Because I'm going to win lots of money. The obvious, really.
Hours and hours she worked on that. I can come up with a more compelling argument.
Yeah?
900th show. Come here, look! Only one of the Power Five missing. She could win a lot of money.
Comet, get a free speaker worth £49 when you buy any iPod Nano, Classic or Touch. Save a total of £74 on this LG 22-inch LCD TV, now only £225. Save £141 on this 3GB Toshiba laptop, only £358. Order these great deals online and collect in-store from only 30 minutes later. Ideal for last-minute Christmas shopping. Comet, click and collect.
This is Spirit of the Glen, Journey. Music of pride and passion. Music to stir the soul. Spirit of the Glen, Journey from the Royal Scots Dragoon Guards. The perfect gift for Christmas.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
New range of 3 for £10 wines. Asda. Why pay more this Christmas?
Hi, Betty. Here's your order.
Jim, you're a lifesaver. Tom and Lucy are coming to lunch. What shall I serve?
Tom, 6. Star Striker. Yes, spaghetti bolognese.
Oh, yes.
And Lucy, 8. Prima ballerina. How about vegetable lasagna?
And I'll have roast beef and Yorkshire pudding. That's for you. And
thank
this
you.
Is for
thank you.
You. Is that delicious?
Gran, this is amazing.
How did you know what we'd like?
Grandma's know everything.
Call now for your free Wiltshire Farm Foods brochure.
Starting in tomorrow's Daily Mail, free Christmas money off shopping vouchers worth £75 at your favourite stores. There's £10 off at Waitrose for every Daily Mail reader. Plus great savings at other top high street names. Don't miss your free Christmas money off shopping vouchers, starting with £10 off at Waitrose, inside tomorrow's Daily Mail.
It's Friday night, it's 9 o'clock, and we're live. I hope you're ready.
Tonight on Cook Along, Gordon's spicing things up with a curry night.
Let's go.
He'll be joined in the kitchen by Alan Carr.
It's live and it's nice.
And goes back to the floor in a busy Turkish restaurant.
Guys, I need some form of help here, yeah?
Gordon Ramsay's Cook Along Live continues tonight at 9 on 4.
She's a trainee nurse at the moment, and she is our 900th player, a fact that has not gone unnoticed by the rest of the world of show business. We're delighted the Spice Girls have joined us here. Posh, be quiet. Where are you going? Stop it. Stop. We've got one giggler. We don't need more. Thank you. Right. Where are you going?
Sorry. Jean, number 20.
Auntie, wake up!
She's mummy now.
And Lisa, wish you all the best, love.
Thank you.
I'll try my best to do a blue. Okay, ready for this?
35,000. Oh, no, the noise says it all. A&E. I thought it was lovely. I was very, very touched that the stars had turned out for our 900th show. Yes, yes, Old Spice Girl. Splash it behind your ears. I want to be, I really, really want to be in bed early. We were doing all right till the 35,000. Yeah. You said you wanted something special, and even though you took 35,000, he's going up to 9,900. Ooh, everybody says. That's interesting. Immediately Stan says excellent. Immediately Jackie says good offer. Immediately Vincenzo says, what's happening? Why are they all clapping?
What do you think?
Richard, that's a very good offer, darling.
Very
but
good.
There's still lots to play for.
And yeah, that.
Six higher boxes.
Yeah.
That's a good piece.
While that 250 is there, you're in charge, aren't you?
Okay, I'm ready for the question.
Where would you like it? 9,900 pounds. Deal or no deal?
No deal.
Thank you.
Carrie, number 7, please.
Carrie, please, box number 7.
Best of luck, Lisa.
Please keep it going. It's going so well. Oh! Well, that's killed the confetti dream.
Number 9, please.
Okay, Ellen.
But Lisa, it's going to be really quiet.
Yeah! We're back.
Lucy, 17, please.
Best of luck, Lisa.
Hello, banker. Yes, Lucy saved her. You've forgiven Lucy, have you? Oh, my word. He's sounding very serious. He says, I think I love her. You've turned his head and it's worked out for you. He doesn't know whether it's the 900th show or his growing affection for Lucy. But he's sticking. 9,900 again. Woo! Yeah. Even though you lost the quarter of a million, 9,900.
Lisa, just not to forget how close to 10,000 that is, 9,000. Sometimes it can sound like less than it is.
Yeah, I know.
As Noel says, sometimes place it on that board.
I know. Thank you.
Leon. Seven reds, four blues. The odds are in your favour, definitely.
Yeah.
One of these.
You can ask me a question. Come on.
£9,900. Deal or no deal?
No deal.
Thank you. On we go.
Reese, number 19, please.
Come on, brains. Keep us on the left-hand side if you can.
I'm really worried these glasses are a bad, bad omen, so do you want me to take them off to unseal the box? I've had the quarter of a million.
He's had the quarter of a million, the 35,000 since he started wearing the glasses.
I think so. I think that's probably.
Because you don't need them for.
I can't see yet. As long as you can see it, it's okay.
Thanks, brains. Oh, you're not brains anymore.
I know.
Oh.
I'm Superman now. I was Clark Kent before. I'm Superman now. This can be a blue for you, Reese.
You're Reese. Come on, let's keep it going. Come on. With or without glasses, you're getting a reputation, Reese.
Rich, number 11.
I was a blue, Lisa.
Go!
Look.
Come on, Penny.
Hold it! Hopefully, Ryan is not going to reveal 100,000. Trainee nurse goes away with £100,000. Do you like that story?
Definitely.
Come back and see her live happily ever after.
Love Christmas. Busy though, so much to do. But it is great getting everyone together.
Oh, they look good, Sarah. You'd be lucky to get a bowl of nuts at mine.
It's not rocket science. Just cook them all together.
Hey, you're supposed to be handing those round.
Another one, Mum.
Lovely mince pies, Sarah. Did you bake them yourself?
Actually, she did.
Sainsbury's in-store baked mince pies. Buy one, get one free.
Oh, any mince pies left?
It'll cost you.
This is Dreamboats and Petticoats 2. Over 50 original hits from a golden era in music. Relive the time of your life with unforgettable tracks. Music never sounded so good. Dreamboats and Petticoats 2, out now.
At Homebase, with up to 75% off artificial Christmas trees and lights, we've great offers to help make anywhere a home for less this Christmas. Homebase.
When love comes.
You are unique. You are magnifique. The new feminine fragrance, Lancôme.
Do
sure you have the code. The Armani Code. Dragons for Men by Giorgio Armani.
This is Christmas Hits. Last Christmas. Four CDs of crackers to make your Christmas go with a bang. 80 festive favourites, including a bonus disc of Christmas carols. The only album you need this Christmas is Christmas Hits. Out now.
Announcing the WH Smith up to half price gift sale. This prepaid Nokia 1208 is half price. Hello? A Navigo sat nav for under £70? Get out of here. And this digital photo frame is half price. Gorgeous. Christmas gift sale. Think WH Smith.
Standing at the front of the queue, heading for trouble. Hope it changes.
Will Young is back. And you know what? He's better than ever. Will Young, Let It Go. The outstanding new album, out now.
Great value at PC World this Christmas on a huge range of laptops. Including this amazing Advent with a dual-core processor for under £294. With its stylish design, DVD player, built-in webcam and genuine Windows Vista Home Basic, it really is a great all-rounder. Or get it free when you sign up to mobile broadband with T-Mobile in store. PC World.
It's Friday night chaos here as we'll interact ostriches with Bernie Clifton. Nick Knowles is here to talk wildlife and Gemma Jones on her Spooks finale. We should be making a beautiful Christmas gift. Buster earmuffs plus our Susan. Stop it! It's a cowgirl in Dallas. So if you're looking, ow, I see a five.
Back to Lisa's Game. Lisa Barnard, a trainee nurse from Clacton-on-Sea. You would love to win enough money for a dream honeymoon. And a few other things to start off married life very positively.
Yes.
And this box is certainly going to give us the shape of the game. Away you go, Ryan.
Good luck.
Yeah! Oh, that's looking good. Do you want to get it or shall I?
Can I get it?
Yeah, why not?
Hello? Do you? It's trying to get to you through me. Do you? I could give you a few tips in exchange for some more money. Okay. Yeah. Okay. You heard me, sister. What is that all about? £10,900. In exchange for tips about Lucy.
What did you say? What?
£10,900.
So he's sticking with the 900 because that's our 900th game.
Peace. An awful lot of reds there. 10,900's a nice amount of money. And there's more chance of you hitting reds now. Think very careful. Very, very carefully on this one. It's an important round to you.
I think six reds
If you took three out, you're still left with three. The odds are still in your favour. Take one blue out, the offer's got to go up.
I'm ready for the question.
£10,900. Deal or no deal?
No deal.
Thank you.
My other half said to me before he went away that you've had a great time and just to give it a shot.
Excellent. Good for him.
So, Mark, number 12.
Good luck, Lisa. I hope it's blue.
Okay. Unfortunately, that is one of the ingredients of the nightmare round, so we don't want 20,000 or 100,000. Let's say that's the one hit.
Jackie, number 21, please.
Okay, we do not want now to go higher than £5,000. Thank you, Jackie.
Good luck, Lisa.
That's okay.
That's okay.
Try and find the one penny, because the penny will drag down the next offer.
Butch, number 3.
Psychologically speaking, the loss of the 1p is a fantastic win for you.
Gonna miss you loads, Lisa. Love you to bits.
See you, mate.
What a disappointment. But you gave it your best shot, and we still have £20,000 in this game. Could be sitting here in box 2. Hello. When it's in the last box, he always thinks it is deliciously cruel. However, all right, he was pointing out that was very cruel at the end, but the good news, and he said it a lot recently, so guys, just remember it when it's your turn. He always rewards courage. He thinks this is, quote, eminently dealable, unquote. £4,900. Instant tuts from everybody else, but do the average.
Good offer, Lisa.
Good offer.
Did you say to Jimmy and Julian you were going all the way?
No, he told me to.
He told you to go all the way?
Yep. But I don't know if I want to go home without anything.
What would you do with it?
What would I do with it? Well, obviously, some money for my wedding. One of my brothers has got a baby on the way, and he hasn't got a lot of money, so I'd like to throw some his way if I went away with some, because he works hard. Ask me the question.
£4,900. Deal or no deal?
So what? No deal.
Where did that come from? Where did that come from?
Number 8.
Leo. Yeah?
You're so brave, Lisa. Right. Your smile has lit up our group for the last couple of weeks. It's been brilliant. All right? Hope it's a blue.
Yeah! on the verge of a guaranteed £3,000.
Oh, come on. Sam, 10, please. Actually.
Oh. Remember, the boxes don't have a history.
Just go. Are you sure? Yeah, go.
Okay.
Just go.
Okay, she wavered for a moment.
10, Sam.
But it's a guarantee 3,000 if this is 1p. Thank you. Come on, Lisa, you've giggled your way up to this point and now you've touched us all with what you want to do with the money. We talked about the swing, whether you turn to the left or turn to the right. Here, you're in the east wing and it's the same thing. Go left and find 3,000.
Go right, Alex 6, because that one is looking at me.
Alex, open box 6, please. We want 3,000. We really want 3,000. Come on, go, go, go! Ah! Oh!
And I've still got 10 or 3.
Yeah, 10 or 3 and something in between.
At the end of the day, I've enjoyed this game already, so let's find it.
Well, we are going to find an interesting climax here. You seem to have found an inner strength, a little bit of a feisty, gambling Lisa.
Yeah.
It's been a revelation. Hello. Saved by the last box. Yep. Each round, saved by the last box. Oh, I agree. Thank you. He says you have made some of the bravest no deals he can remember.
Really?
You were at 4,900. You've taken the 20,000 out. But your offer is 5,900. Oh, come on that.
That's good. That's really good.
Look, do the maths. The average is 6.5. That is sensational. Some people groaned. The average.
That's really.
The average is 6,500.
That's a good offer.
5,900. That is an exceptional offer, given the circumstances. He's not egging you on, Lisa. £5,900, may I suggest, Lisa, is a very considerable amount of money. On the other hand, 10,000 is more.
I have this devil on my shoulder at the moment.
Is it a devil or is it an angel guide?
Lisa, if you took home £3,000 and you'd be more than happy to take £3,000 then, that's a lot of money to, if you won't go for it then. Because that's the worst that can happen and still be really happy.
That's exactly what I'm thinking. I'd be happy with either of those amounts because both of them are going to...
Good, that's simple then.
Yeah, come on, let's just do it.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Honestly?
Yeah.
Okay. No. £5,900. Deal or no deal?
No deal. I know you're going to do this.
Hello. Hey, that's a statement worth savouring and taking away. You have graced our 900th show. We've had 899 players before you, but none finer.
Oh, that's really nice. Thank you.
Therefore, your friend the banker is now saying, yes, you may have a swap if you wish.
Oh, I knew you were going to do that.
So, did you and your fiancé talk about that scenario?
No. Considering I've made it this far, ask me the question.
It's swap or no swap?
No swap.
No swap. Would you kindly sit down? Find out your fate. Lisa, I think that was a generous statement by the banker.
It was.
But I've done this 900 times. Well, no, 899 times.
Gosh.
And the 900th time, I really do hope I am going to reveal to the player the maximum money remaining in the game. You've turned into a very, very feisty player. You most certainly are worthy of sitting in that chair on our 900th. Here it comes. You're going to have to look. Come on, you got to look. Okay? Would you please complete the game and show us where that elusive money was? £10,000.
Really enjoyed that.
I'm delighted with what you just said. You really enjoyed it.
I did.
Yeah. I enjoyed it. Did we all enjoy?
Yeah!
Love your attitude. Good. Well, we're going to miss you because we've had plenty of giggles.
I know. I've had the best few weeks. It's been great.
You're all right. I don't know how to end this show because I'm going to miss you. You've been so fantastic.
Can I
over
stay
there
for a while longer?
Yeah, stay for a bit. I tell you what, that's a very good idea. Come back and see if Lisa is still sitting in the chair with me.
Deal or No Deal's back Sunday at 5:15. It's Paul O'Grady next, then.
At Halfords, we're bursting with bright ideas, like up to 50% off our entire range of sat-nav. There's 50% off this Navman, 50% off this Becca, 50% off this Navigon. Plus, you can reserve online and collect in-store. Don't miss up to 50% off all sat-nav at Halfords and Halfords.com now.
Davidoff Cool Water, the power of cool.
For her, Davidoff Cool Water Woman.
Out Monday.
Let me put this to you as delicately as I can.
Load up Hellboy 2, The Golden Army.
Excuse me.
On 2-disc special edition DVD and Blu-ray.
Make the choice.
Packed with over 4 hours of spectacular extras.
You woke up the baby.
Hellboy 2, The Golden Army. Own it Monday.
I'm a PC. And I am not alone.
I'm a PC.
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 I'm a PC, and so is my mom.
And these are my grandchildren.
I'm a PC, and I teach them.
Yeah. I'm a PC.
Oui. Yo también.
Kula. What?
I'm PC. I'm PC.
I'm a PC, just like BG.
We're all a PC, inseparably one.
You got a problem with that?
Sleep even better this Christmas with an adjustable bed from Great British Mobility. And if you order any bed from our Premier range today, we'll not only give you a second bed absolutely free, or a rise and recline chair if you prefer, but deliver them both in time for Christmas. Guaranteed. With interest-free credit for 12 months, call 0800 048 0044. Great British Mobility. Helping you live your life.
Selected premium spirits for only £9.99 is just one of hundreds of new offers at Summerfield this week. For fresh offers this Christmas, pop into Summerfield.
Gavin and Stacey are back in their fantastic second DVD.
I was on my honeymoon.
Can we all stop calling it a honeymoon?
Take a chill pill, Stace. Keep it real.
Get the hilarious Gavin and Stacey Series 2. Out now on DVD.
I know.
Know what?
Santa Claus, he's not real.
If I could make you believe, then there'd be some hope for me.
We're going to prove that there is a Santa Claus and that you're him.
Richard Attenborough stars in the Christmas classic.
Miracle on 34th Street. Sunday at 6:20 on 4.
Have Homer and Marge lost their sparks? The Simpsons at 6. First on 4, Nick Knowles is in to join Paul O'Grady.
Chevrolet sponsored the Paul O'Grady Show. Great value. Without the nonsense.
Billy, I can't control this thing.
Tonight, Gemma Jones, Nick Knowles, Bernie Clifton, and a Buster exclusive. Welcome, Paul O'Grady.
Hey up. Say hello, Olga. Hello, folks. You okay? Yes. Yay! Welcome to Friday's show. Leave those alone, please, Olga, because I should be making those later on. Would you like to go and sit? Oh, why did she do this? Sitting on me post. Should we read the letters out? OK. Dear Buster and Olga, you've got to mention Olga, how's Paul these days? Is he in good health? Looking at him on the telly, he looks pale. Unless the makeup that's been applied is the wrong colour. And I could ask how long it takes for it to set. Mine takes forever, 61 years. And I've plenty of potholes for it to sink in and slide down my face. This is depressing me, this. You want to see me without a bit of makeup? I'm blue grey. I look like I've just been dug up in it with the shovel. There you go. Dear Paul, are you really as innocent as you make out? Oh, yes. Aren't I? Yes. Aren't I? Yes. Aren't I? Yes. See, sometimes on the show, you seem very surprised when a guest tells you something naughty. Well, I've led a sheltered life. But I don't buy it. Admit it, you've lived. I haven't, honestly. I was in a boarding school till I was 38. And then I was a cleaner, like. And then I went straight from that. So haven't we led a sheltered life, me and you, Olga? I've lived. Oh, never mind, don't start arding, please. Christmas songs are driving me mad on the telly as it is without you going, oh. Dear Paul, I hope you are feeling fit after your snake bite. It's always a mistake to mix cider and beer. Yes, that's true. Dear Paul, at New Year, we are going to Edinburgh for 4 days. Oh, lovely. My dad wants to wear a kilt to a nice restaurant. Well, that's what they do up there at New Year. Everyone in my family has tried to talk him into not wearing it, but he won't listen. He thinks it will make him fashionable. The thing is, his leg's like an ape. Not nicely shaved ones either. And none of my family want to be walking around with an ape wearing a kilt. Poor dad. Could you shout out, Carl, don't wear a kilt. It would make our day. Thanks a million. Rachel, Michelle, David, Hannah and Carl Border. Carl, wear a kilt, but don't wear underpants. Yeah? That's what you want to do. You want to wear a kilt. Take the notice of them. And when you've had a few scoops, lift it up at midnight. Says, how's that for ding-dong bells? Right. Should see me in a kilt. I was up in Scotland once for the Edinburgh Festival and we all went out in kilts and we hired them because I left it too late, so mine was a bit big for me. Actually, it came down to my ankles. And then he had Dr. Martin boots. I remember coming down the stairs in the hotel and somebody shouted, oh, Lord, it's olive oil. Because it hangs on me. Imagine what it looks like. What else have I got here? Let's see. Dear Paul, I have a really annoying little brother called Ben, oh, me and you together, who loves your show, and he really, really, really wants a nodding Buster, so would you please send him one to shut him up? I will be ever for grateful to you. Love from Abigail, age 10. And there they are. Right, Ben, there's a nodding Buster on your way, on its way to you. Put it on top of the telly. You've got the same colour hair as me when I was a kid. Bright red. Dear Paul, have you noticed Buster looks more like the Queen Mother every day? No? Can you see a similarity to Boston and the Queen Mother? Laundry's going round very regal lately. There you go. Olga, shove up a bit, please. Buster looks like the Queen Mother. You're a bit Princess Margaret, are you? Dear Paul, could you please show this photo of the smile collectors who give up their spare time to visit poorly children in hospital? The clowns' names are Mr. Sparkle, Pom Pom, Rainbow and Feathers. I bet they're fun when you're lying in hospital. Having Mr. Sparkle angle over to your bed. Mr. Sparkle and Pom Pom, Roy and Sue Strangeways, main jobs are funeral directors. And there they are. So you're lying in hospital, feeling terrible, and in comes a clown, and you say, to be polite, what you do for a main job? I'm a funeral director. I mean, Dad would you, wouldn't he? Wouldn't he? No? Oh, well, oh, no, good for you going round the hospitals. And now, finally, the birthdays. We've got happy 50th birthday to Deepak Puri, and there he is, from all his family and friends. With the wig on, I think. Happy birthday to Joanna Giorgio from all the family. Jessica Ruby Mullen, who's 2 today. Bradley O'Reilly, who's 11 years old today. And on the birthday mug, we have Lennon, who's 2. And I'd like to say a big happy 17th birthday to Sam, who's in our audience tonight. There you go. Nice lad, Sam. Before we came on, he was stripping, wasn't he? Yeah. We have a little cabaret, you know, just before. Oh, and finally, I kind of say congratulations to my son, John. Not my son, John. Their son, John, you know, just in case. To their son, John, and his girlfriend, Charlene, on the birth of their beautiful baby son, Benjamin. £6, 12 ounces on the 27th of November. And there's that gorgeous baby. Look at him. There you go. Another man. Lord. So that's it. Right. Well, we have got a trio of top guests for you tonight. We've got the man who's going to teach me how to ride an ostrich. That's the one and only Mr. Bernie Clifton. Yay! Good girly. We've also got the double agent who's trying to bring down MI5. The dastardly Connie from Spooks. That's Miss Gemma Jones. Yay! Plus, the DIY SOS star who's now turning our gardens into wildlife havens, Mr. Nick Knowles. And it's, as it's that time of the year, you know, where you make things. Well, they did on Blue Peter, didn't they? I'm going to have my Valerie Singleton moments as I teach you how to make these beautiful. I mean, look at them. I'm going to teach you to make these. So I hope you get all your stuff ready at home. I'm going to teach you to make these beautiful earmuffs, Buster earmuffs. Look. Look. See? They're nice, Olga. Look. Look at your old man. Look. Do you think I'll get stared at in the supermarket? Yeah, get stared at anyway, so it makes no difference. We've also got a herd of ostriches at the end of the show, which we will be riding. So, don't go anywhere. See you after the break. These are nice.